I believe I met most of you in the United States.
这个里根总统啊，中美建交以后第一位啊美国的在职总统来华访问，说这是中美关系史上的一件大事啊，我们对他的来访啊表示热烈的欢迎。
President Reagan is the first incumbent American president to visit China since the establishment of diplomatic relations between China and the United States. We regard his visit here as a major event in the annals of our bilateral relations, so we express warm welcome to him.
友好的会见，今天上午、下午我将同总统先生进行会谈。今天下午他还要同我们的胡耀邦总书记这个会见，明天上午啊将要同邓小平主任会谈。这些都是很重要的会谈和会晤。 将会就我们共同关心的国际问题和双边关系进行广泛的交换意见。我们呢理所当然的希望他的这一次访问将对稳定和这个持久的发展中美关系做出贡献。Yesterday,
President Li Xianyan had a friendly meeting with President Reagan. This morning and this afternoon, I'm going to have talks with President Reagan. And this afternoon, General Secretary Hu Yaobang is going to meet him. Tomorrow morning, Chairman Deng Xiaoping is going to have a talk with him. All these meetings and talks are very important, in which both sides will have an extensive exchange of views on international issues of common concern as well as bilateral relations. We naturally expect that the current visit by President Reagan in China will contribute to the stable and sustained development of Sino-US relations.
我们的会谈很快就开始了，我想还有几分钟时间呢，如果你们有问题的话，我愿意做简要的回答。
The talks will begin very soon. Now there are a few minutes left. I will take up your questions if you have any.
Mr. Mayor, may I ask you, sir, the president, President Reagan, has been an ardent anti-communist and has often denounced your country in the harshest terms. How do you and your colleagues feel having him in your midst?
What agency do you represent?
I represent ABC News.
美国广播公司的人问啊，他说那个里根总统呢，经常是一个激烈的反对共产主义的人，他常常用非常激烈的言辞啊来谴责中国的。你们你和你的同事啊，对他到这里来是如何感觉的？我认为，一个有远见的政治家都会看到这么一点。
现在在按照意识形态来划分国家之间是友好的还是敌对的，已经是过时了。我的感觉是，里根总统也认识了这一点。
I think any politician with vision will see that it is an outmoded idea to distinguish nations. For friendly or hostile nations on the basis of ideology. I feel that President Reagan is aware of it.
Mr. Premier, on the question.
NBC.
Can you tell us how much of an obstacle is it that the President still continues selling arms to Taiwan?
全国广播公司的记者问。 那个总统现在继续要对台湾出售武器，你认为这个障碍有多么严重？
台湾问题仍然是中啊
中美关系稳定持久发展的一个重要的障碍。这个我们注意到，美国政府已经多次表示他们将严格遵守中美之间的三个公报。我们希望在这个方面，美国能够有更多的实际行动。
The question of Taiwan remains a major obstacle to the stable, sustained development of Sino-US relations. We have taken note of the fact that the American government has stated on several occasions that it intends to strictly abide by the three joint communiques concluded between China and the United States. We hope that we can see more actual action in this regard.
Mr. Premier, what is the message of this CBS News?
What is your name?
Leslie Stahl, CBS News.
Columbia.
Mr. Premier, what is the message of this visit to the Soviet Union?
This is the President of the Soviet Union. What is the message of this visit to the Soviet
Union? 我同李根总统会谈以后，他可能会告诉你们，因为我跟从李根总统今天才开始会谈，现在还没开始，所以我不能告诉你他可能告诉我什么信息。他说对苏联，对苏联将会，苏联会产生什么情况？在产生什么？我想这个道道理，如果我是苏联领导人的话，对李根总统到华访问。 对中苏中美关系，不会反对。至于这个苏联领导人呢，他们究竟会采取什么态度，我不知道。现在是。
Well, if I were a Soviet leader, I wouldn't object to President Reagan's visit to China and the development of Sino-US relations. But I don't know what will be the attitude of the Soviet leadership.
Mr. Premier,
please, last question.
Mr. Premier, Bill Plant from CBS News. May I ask you, Mr. Premier, if it is it since this is an election year in the United States?
Mr.
Premier, are you satisfied that the nuclear cooperation agreement this country will sign with the United States does not infringe Chinese sovereignty? CNN, cable news network.
有线广播公司，他问你，就是中美关于签订的核作的协定，你是不是认为它并不侵犯中国的主权？这个你们都已经知道了，中美关于和平利用核能的协定，这个谈判呢，从我到华盛顿访问的时候已经开始了，中间有一个困难的问题，就是所谓统一权的问题。 双方代表本着合作的精神，并且由于他们的聪明，终于找到了一个既符合中国的主权原则，又不违反美国法律的这样一个解决办法，我对此感到满意。好了，很感谢你。谢谢。
As you know, the negotiations on the cooperation of peaceful use of nuclear energy was started when I visited Washington. The difficulty in the negotiation was the consent right. Through the cooperation of the delegations of both sides in the spirit, in the cooperative spirit, and thanks to their wisdom, finally we have found a solution which conforms to China's sovereignty as well as to the law of the United States. I'm satisfied with it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Please move on. Please.
Thank you, Mr. President.
President Reagan in the hall outside the Eastern Room in the People's Hall.
Did you have a nice sleep last night?
Please stand. Thank you, President.